What's up, motherfuckers? What up, what up, what up? Tiana, FOL, C to C.
If you're a new company, I mean, unless it's like some new industry or new market that, if it's an untapped market, or you have more ability to, the standard is lower for your product or service. But if you're entering anything where there's an existing marketplace against large entrenched competitors, then your product or service needs to be much better than theirs. It can't be a little bit better, because then you put yourself in the shoes of the consumer and they say, why would you buy it as a consumer? You're always going to buy the trusted brand unless there's a big difference.
Fine fellow. Heavy responsibilities.
Yes, but he has a struggle to keep up his position, and he's far from rich. You noticed, of course, that his boots have been resold.
Really?
You got this.
Out of breath.
I'm aware what tremendous feats human beings are capable of once they abandon dignity. May I smoke my pipe as well?
Go and make yourself at home.
Now, my job dictates that I must have my men enter your home.
Everybody's staring. First time you see something, trying to get your attention.
You're smoking, Matt.
Hmm. Well, you've seen a man smoke a pipe before.
Well, we've never seen you smoke a pipe.
Well, lots of the literary men on the campus are smoking them.
And night watchmen?
My professor, Professor Parks, claims that his pipe is an aid to his concentration.
Besides, it scares away the mosquitoes, Esther.
Do look kind of professory.
All right, John Boy, this joke has gone far enough. I'm not going to have tobacco stinking up my living room, not to mention what it's doing to your lungs.
Pipe smokers do not take the smoke into their lungs. I should get back to work.
It's a rabbit smoking a pipe.
A rabbit smoking a pipe. Why in the world would that be, Charles?
It's a symbol of the Cree Indians. On one side is the panther, on the other his prey, the rabbit. He sits unafraid. He smokes his pipe. It's a traditional motif.
Why is he unafraid?
Because he's smarter than the panther.
Huh. Sir, you impress me.
Oh. Thank you.
Amazing accomplishment.
No, it's not an accomplishment. It's a freak.
Is that so?
Yeah. I seem to retain all these facts, but putting them to any useful purpose is another matter.
All right, you want to see Trick, man?
Hey, Jackal.
Yeah. Bite down, killer. Here comes the fun. All right. Ah, good boy, Jackal. Good boy. Breathe deep. There you go.
Can I see your pipe?
Very protective of his pipe. When other people touch it, it does not light.
Sorry, Jackal.
Yeah, see, he's sorry. Holy crap.
That's one psycho dog, dude. Yeah. Get out of here, Dewey.
What are y'all doing in here?
We're smoking reefer, and you don't want no part of this shit.
You're smoking reefers?
Yeah, of course we are. Can't you smell it?
No, Sam. I can't.
Come on, Dewey. Join the party.
No, Dewey. You don't want this. Get out of here.
You know what? I don't want no hangover. I can't get no hangover.
It doesn't give you a hangover.
Well, I get addicted to it or something?
It's not habit forming.
Okay, well, I don't know. I don't want to overdose on it.
You can't OD on it.
It's not going to make me want to have sex, is it?
It makes sex even better.
It sounds kind of expensive.
It's the cheapest drug there is.
Hmm.
You don't want it.
I think I kind of want it.
Okay, but just this once. Come on in.
What do?
Like this.
I will make sure that it's good or it won't be on sale. The people that I'm involved with are very good at what they do. They've been doing it a while, you know, and our product will be...
Old Tovey, the finest weed in the South Valley. Gandalf, my old friend, this will be a night to remember.
Just try it. Try it.
Please, don't stop pressuring her.
How does she know she doesn't like it if she's never tried it before?
You know, we should probably be getting back.
Just fucking do it. Weed is awesome. Hold it in.
Just blow it out.
Hold it in.
Blow it out. Okay. Then I'm gonna take this.
I'm gonna go find a hot dog.
Fire that shit up, boy.
I'm about to show y'all who the real Puff Daddy is.
Take that, son.
You know what your problem is? You're all brains, not enough cock and balls.
Actually, people have been telling me that my whole life, believe it or not. When I was in the sixth grade, I got so worried about the escalating situation in Iraq that they put me on an adult dosage of Xanax. And by eighth grade, I was in therapy 3 times a week. And the truth is, weed is the only thing that could ever balance me out. You know what I mean? Like, You okay over there?
Hey, old man. I got the fucking munchies real bad. How about you?
Okay, the thing about the great beyond is... we invented it!
What?
I know, right? As soon as you're out those doors, the gods kill our asses.
What, are you crazy? That doesn't make any sense. Why would the gods want to kill us? That makes no sense.
Because it makes them stronger. Every kill gives them more power, and it's never enough. Over the years, they've grown bigger, stronger, fatter. The hunger's insatiable, buddy. I mean, fuck.
You guys are fucking nuts. How much of that shit have you been smoking? Too fucking much is how much.
We blaze for real 24/7, no joke. But we also know our shit. Before us, everyone knew the awful truth. Oh, how they screamed. It was a living nightmare. So we, the non-perishables, created a story. The story of the great beyond. A place where the gods care for you. And all your wildest and wettest dreams would come true. They would go out those doors happy, instead of shitting themselves.
Wait.
Boom. The melody came to me one night. The song had a great hook, and it caught on, I mean, you know. In time, everyone accepted this false truth. But over the years, things started to get a little fucky. The Isles started changing my verses to support their own views. Fucking with Twink's tight-ass lyrics, remixing my shit without my permish. Now, every morning when I hear the song, I'm like, what the fuck are you guys saying? I mean, wasn't there a part today about exterminating juice? I didn't write that shit. I love juice. Always have. I mean, juice are hilarious. Who the fuck do these guys think they are? Anyway, at least it's still distracting them from the truth that they get brutally devoured.
Holmes, there's just one thing I don't understand. If the Colonel's name was James, and Wood was called either Henry or Harry, then who the deuce was David?
Ah, my dear Watson, that name David should have told me the whole story. Had I been the ideal reasoner, which you are so fond of depicting, but alas, my powers of deduction failed me. You see, David, in this case, was evidently used as a term of reproach.
Reproach?
Do you feel death? Do you feel that dark abyss?
Life is cruel. Why should the afterlife be any different? I offer you a choice. Join my crew and postpone the judgment.
Right now I'm lighting up a cob full of Casey Jones Heroes Blend.
He knew.
Lily, make big chief heap glad.
Well, he certainly doesn't look heap glad.
Make Peter Pan heap big chief. You now, little flying eagle. Teach him, pale-faced brother, all about Red Man.
Good. This should be most enlightening.
What makes the Red Man red?
When did he first say, say,
Why does he ask you how?
Why does he ask you how?
Why does he ask you how? What's the engine didn't know all the things that he know now? But the engine, he sure learned a lot, and it's all from asking how. We translate for you. Hanna means what Mana means, and Gala means that Mana.
No dance. Get him firewood.
When did he first say, oh? When did he first say, oh? In the engine book it say, when first break married squaw, he came out with heat big mouth when he saw his mother-in-law. Some maid and start to blush, and
we've all been blushing since.
You cried right from the head, man. The real true story of the Red Man. No matter what's been written or said,
now you know why the Red Man's red.
Firewood.
Squaw, no get him firewood. Squaw, go home.